बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ उमैरा सईद, लेक्चरर इंग्लिश टाइम्स इंस्टीट्यूट। सो हियर वी आर विद द लेक्चर नंबर 4 ऑफ इंट्रोडक्शन टू मैथ्स कम्युनिकेशन, एंड द टॉपिक विच आई हैव चूजन फॉर यू टुडे इज सेवन सीज। सो पिक आउट योर पेंसिल एंड द पेपर्स टू राइट डाउन द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स। योर नोट्स विल बी प्रोवाइडेड इन योर व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप, एंड प्लीज सबमिट योर असाइनमेंट्स इन द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप एज वेल। सो स्टार्टिंग विद द एजेंडा, the today's session agenda is that we discuss all the seven C's and what are their pros and the cons and how these are called the effective communication skills. As we discussed in the previous lectures that communication is a bilateral process, there are four basic communication skills like listening, speaking, reading and writing. We discussed that two are the active skills, two are the passive skill, and writing is one of those skills which are more active. Like you are not bound by anything, you may write freely whatever comes in your mind, so writing based on that. In the oral and the written communication, the effectivity is very much important. The more persuasive, influencing and effective it is, the more communication have a great impact on the listeners and the readers. So we have the seven C's. So let's discuss. The seven C's starts with completeness, conciseness, clarity, concreteness, courtesy, correctness and clarity. So my dear students, now starting it one by one. What is completeness? The message must be very complete. Suppose, let me give you an example. If I send you a message that there will be a get together in college, like in Times Institute, and I float this message in your group, what will happen? Definitely you will bother to ask who, what, when, where, why, how, because the message which I sent to you was incomplete, because you would ask that who is going to throw the party, what is the purpose of party, when it will be, where it will be, why it will be, and how it will be arranged in this pandemic. So it means that my message was incomplete. So while sending a message to another party, while constructing a message, while preparing the message must be complete. So this is the most important thing in preparing the message, that it has a complete information. Many of you are familiar with the wedding cards, with the birthday cards. They never said that ABC weds XYZ, but they also give you all the plans that this is the time for the matrimonials, this will be the time for the lunch, and this will be time for this. So the wedding card is the most appropriate example of a complete message. Okay, so this is we discussed in completeness, that there must be complete message. The other is the conciseness. As we discussed, that there must be conciseness in your message. Must, like, there should not be any lengthy message. Try to compose your words, try to compose your message in the few possible lines or the few possible words. If I say you that I am really thankful to you for giving me this much honor, thank you so much that you are listening to my lectures, you are appreciating me, you are working according to my demands, you are working according to my schedule. So I just spoke 3 to 4 lines, but what happens, it may be composed, thank you for appreciation my dear students. So which one is more concise, the previous message or the message which I said in the letter? It means that the conciseness, like the smallest message has a more effect than the longest message. As you are the students of mass communication, and in the coming days we will discuss about the news, how to prepare the radio news, how to prepare the newspaper, the makeup of the newspaper, then you will find that how the largest news is just composed into the few possible words. When you used to narrate a road accident, how you make a headline, how you make the sub headlines, that will all be dependent upon these seven C's. If you have a command over these 7 Cs, the making of the news, the preparation, writing of the news, the giving the caption, that will be said more easy for you. So let me give you another example. You know what is essay? You know what is the title of an essay? Sometimes the title of an essay or the title of a story justify the whole of the content. If I say the thirsty crow, greedy dog, union is strength. So everything you predict that what is going to happen next, because you know that the greedy dog is simply the story about a dog. Like rather reading of the whole story, you cannot understand the moral message, but with the greedy dog you understand what will be the moral message. So this is called the conciseness. The next is consideration. Consideration, that how do you consider the other person? It is being said that only the wearer knows where the shoe pinches. Consideration means that you have to live into another person's place. It is also been said that only the cook knows the heat of kitchen. It means that only your mothers know that how much it is hot these days to cook in the kitchen. Like you can, when you feel like others, you feel the pain like them. So consideration is that you have to feel that if you are conveying a message, that must not be so harsh. Suppose if I am sending a message to you and I am using some violent and the harsh words in it, and if I am feeling that if my student will listen or read this message, it will hurt them, then I remove that message and write some consoling words in that. But if I do not care that whatever happens or whatever you think I just wrote down, it means that I am not taking care of the effectivity of in the communication. I am just throwing the message, and the message will be wasted. It will not be more influencing. So consideration is just to remove ambiguity, vagueness, but think that like you are thinking for yourself. Use the simple words, use the very clear words, but there must no be ambiguity, and you must be very considerate while giving the message. Many of you are students, when prepare the message for your own fellows, the message is very clear, and sometimes you use very informal language. But I know that when you prepare and write message to me, your message sometimes have a more respected words. It means that you know that what type of a message should type for the teacher, for your director, for your coordinator, and what kind of a message you have to type for your class fellow. So this is the consideration. The next most important aspect we discussed today is concreteness. Concreteness. Concreteness means that you must have no vague ideas in that. You must know that whatever the fact and the figures, the dates and important information you are giving must not have vagueness in it. If you are quoting a quotation, if you are giving any kind of a date, if you are giving fact and the figures, that must be accurate. If you say that in the days of pandemic in Multan, there are hundreds of patients suffering from this coronavirus. What does this hundreds of patients mean? Is it 100, 200, 500, 800? It means that your message is not clear. There must be clarity. You must say that there are maximum 275 patients that are suffering from severe COVID-19 in Multan, but the rest of the areas are sealed nowadays and few are open, and there is a less movement within the city. It means that now you are giving an accurate information, and this is the concreteness. Write down the next point, which is courtesy. But a courtesy is very much important in your conversation. The more courteous you are, if you are some kind of a shopkeeper, if you are kind of running a business, if you are a teacher, if you are FDO, if you are running your own business, then your courtesy will be your plus point. So now what is this courtesy? You must say thank you, I'm sorry, I'm so humble, so kind of you, please, I need your help, it will be nice of you. These are the words we say courtesy. If you say someone, like let me give you a very common example at your home. Like if you say to younger brother, oh my dear younger brother, bring me or fetch me a glass of water. He will say no, go and take your glass of water by yourself. But if you say टू योर सिस्टर और यंगर ब्रदर, माई डियर सिस्टर, माई स्वीट सिस्टर और माई लवली ब्रदर, प्लीज फेच मी अ ग्लास ऑफ वाटर, देयर रिएक्शन विल बी डिफरेंट. दे वुड से ओके माई डियर ब्रदर, ओके माई डियर सिस्टर, आई विल फेच अ ग्लास ऑफ वाटर फॉर यू. इट मीन्स दैट द टून, योर मैसेज, योर कर्टसी हैव अ ग्रेट इम्पैक्ट. मैनी ऑफ यू पीपल यूजली गो आउट फॉर शॉपिंग. Maybe it is something I am telling you about the past, but not in the present. So just take an example that if you go to the market and purchase some kind of suits or shoes or some other groceries from the shop, have you ever observed the behavior of the shopkeepers? They show so courtesy to you. Sir, this is new thing for you. Sir, it suits you. Sir, thank you so much, sir, for appreciating. So nice of you, sir, so humble you. If they commit some mistake, they say, I'm so sorry, sir. I'm so apologize, sir. So their behavior is so apologetic that your heart begin to melt. So this is the most important point of the effective communication skills, and that is why it has been said that while written, while in the speaking, the courtesy is a kind of that thing that which can melt in every person's heart. Like you can win the hearts of every person, but only with your courteous behavior. Your emotions, your gestures, your behaviors, your words matters a lot if you have a courtesy in it. But the violent and the harsh word arrogance, it never works anywhere. The last is the correctness. The correctness of the message is very important. So write down that there are three levels of the correctness: the formal, informal, and the substandard language. Correctness, first of all, we discussed that the correctness means that while preparing the message, it must be very grammatically correct. The spelling must be correct, the sentence correction must be correct, there must be no ambiguity, there must be no loopholes. You're supposed to write a very correct message in it. Suppose if you are writing a letter or application to your coordinator, and if you are writing a wrong spelling, it would have a bad impact that you are just a student of this good level, like the BS, and you are writing a different wrong spellings. So the wrong spellings also has a bad impact. Write a good language. The formal language, at the formal written message in which the words are so formal, so your formal expressions are used. In the informal, slangs are used in with your friends and your family, so this is the informal. The substandard language is a kind in which the words are homophones. Like you have the same sound, but your meanings are different. Like the pair of words, let me write few of them, like ear and ear, gate, G-A-T-E, gate has one meaning, G-A-I-T, gate has another meaning. Although the sound is same, but their meanings are entirely different. So my dear student, this was the lecture number 4 for today. We will come up with some new topics related with the mass introduction to mass communication with the next week. So stay tuned, stay home, stay safe, and study at your home. Submit your assignments. Till then, thank you so much.